بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Today we are going to talk about the feeding intolerance and what is the indicator of the feeding intolerance. The three indicators, the most indicator for feeding intolerance is vomiting, gastric residual and abdominal distension. Feeding intolerance might be a simple thing and you can treat it easily, and might be its major, it's related to gastroesophageal flux, or might be associated with necrotizing enterocolitis. The second issue, actually, if you have high risk premature infant and you are still doubt about to start feed or not, there is prediction of early tolerance of enteral feeding in premature infant by measuring the superior mesenteric artery blood flow velocity by Doppler ultrasound. There is significant correlations between increase in the mean superior mesenteric artery blood flow velocity and the early tolerance of the enteral feeding. Doppler measurement of the superior mesenteric artery blood flow velocity may be useful for deciding or to take the decision when to feed of the high risk premature infant. So if you are doubting about the feeding intolerance or high risk baby, you can do Doppler ultrasound and check the velocity flow of the superior mesenteric artery. The superior mesenteric artery is increasing in the superior mesenteric artery blood flow velocity, and the early tolerance of the enteral feed, it will correlate with the tolerance of the early feed. So what is the indicators for feeding intolerance? The first indicator is vomiting. So the vomiting is significant or not? I have to ask myself if the baby having vomiting, it's significant or not significant. If a small volume of altered milk or milky, it's usual benign. But if the vomiting consider significant, if frequent vomiting and bloody and bilious vomitus, bilious and bloody vomit, it's considered pathological, and you have to assess your patient clinically and the laboratory and the imaging, and start the management as early as possible. So bilious vomiting, actually it's considered pathological. Yellow vomitus is red flag and signal of the intestinal obstruction, and put in your mind bilious vomiting considered pathological until proved otherwise. For sure, any bilious vomiting considered surgical, and most important cause of the bilious vomiting, it means obstruction distal to ampulla better, and consider malrotation or intestine obstruction until proved otherwise. This is bilious vomiting, always pathological, always until proved otherwise. This is common causes of the vomiting in the premature babies. Might depend on the color. It's milky or blood or bilious. Bilious and the bloody is pathological, and the milky might be its feeding intolerance. So the another indicator for feeding intolerance, it's abdominal distension. Again, you have to ask yourself, it's abdominal distension, this is significant or not significant. You see in the picture in the right side, this is abdominal distension. It's coming from the visual diagnosis from the NeuroView. The abdominal distension with visible abdominal vessels, this actually after we ultrasound and x-ray and exploration by the surgeon, it's come with spontaneous perforations. The other picture, this is visible loopy abdomen. The abdomen is loopy. You can see the loop of the abdomen. It's come later on the baby having surgical cause and the neck necrotizing enterocolitis stage 3. This is abdominal distension. Abdominal distension, it's considered significant or not significant based on the other associated symptoms. Mild abdominal fullness with increased abdominal gas less than 2 cm, especially after bolus of feeding or usual nasal sebab. There is obvious cause of you give just bolus feeding of the baby on the sebab is not uncommon. However, when consider the abdominal distension is significant, if abdominal distension more than 2 cm or more compared to the previous measurement. also abdominal distension associated with bilious gastric residual or bloody gastric residual, it's considered pathological. If you examine the abdomen and there is erythema of the abdominal wall, it's considered significant abdominal distension. So significant abdominal distension, if the abdominal girth more than 2 centimeters from the previous measurement, if associated with bilious or bloody, if you have systemic manifestation or abdominal manifestation, so it's considered as significant abdominal distension, and you have to assess your patient clinically and the laboratory and the imaging and start the management and the consultation if there is any surgical possibilities. So we'll go for the third indicator for feeding intolerance is gastric residual. Gastric residual is data strongly suggested bloody stained residual to less extent maximum residual volume correlated with feeding intolerance and subsequent development of the neck. Gastric residual, if bloody, this means feeding intolerance, and subsequently it's a baby might develop neck or necrotizing enterocolitis. However, gastric residual in absent of other clinical signs and symptoms during trophic feed, it's not considered a significant sign of feeding intolerance. Just so you started the feeding trophic feed and the baby having just gastric residual, small gastric residual and milky, it's not considered significant. The only significant if gastric residual is bloody or bilious, it's correlated with feeding intolerance and subsequent neck, and subsequently it will be subsequently neck. Gastric nowadays is no routine to do gastric aspirate. Just don't do routine gastric aspirate. This is no more practical issues right now. So gastric residual, it's come as bilious or bloody. If bilious or bloody, it's considered pathological. If it's milky, it's considered insignificant. When gastric residual are considered significant, if gastric residual greater than 30% of the previous feed, if there is blood or bile stained gastric residual, if associated with systemic manifestation. So what is the significance of gastric residual if GI and extra GI? GI, if gastric residual more than 30% from the previous feed, and there is gastric residual bloody or bilious. Extra GI is associated with systemic manifestation, the ABC, apnea, bradycardia, circulatory insufficiency, lysargic, hypoactivity, and all of this. So it's considered is pathological. What other, this is what, when gastric residual are considered significant, and I mentioned it, if greater than 30% of the previous feed, if there is blood or bile stained, if associated with systemic manifestations. It associated with systemic manifestation. What other indicator of feeding intolerance? If there is bloody stool, if there is associated with systemic manifestation, what is this systemic manifestation? ABC, apnea, brady, circulatory insufficiency, and the patient having lysargy, hypoactive, it's considered feeding intolerance, and you have to assess your patient clinically, laboratory, and the imaging, and if you have to consult a subspecialty related to such cases and how to manage it will come in next lecture. Thank you.